This is Absolute Radio.
Is it either the cherry on top of the cake, or is it the basis from where everything else grew?
Aren't you clever?
Occasionally.
Yeah, that's right.
You've caught me on a good day.
We've got to watch that Tim Minchin show. It's something to do with a cake.
Good morning. It's the Dave Berry Breakfast Show on Absolute Radio, and it gives me great pleasure to say, swinging by for a chat this morning and maybe a cup of tea, it's comedian, actor, writer, musician, composer, lyricist, and director. It's Tim Minchin. Morning, Tim.
Hello, Dave. How are you?
Good, man. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. Yeah.
I must start with, and there's a lot of kind of grown-ups in this room. Well, you know, age-wise.
Yeah.
We're so in love with Matilda, and it's a gift that you've kind of given the world. It's such a special thing to go and see. We all absolutely love it. We all want to go and see it again. It must feel fantastic to be part of something so universally loved.
It's all right, isn't it? Yeah.
It's amazing.
It's very much the sort of most ridiculous stroke of luck in a fairly lucky ride for me is getting involved in that. And it changed my life in so many ways, just working with brilliant people and how much I learned and how much it got me back into theatre, which is where I really came from. But, yeah, also that thing where I think with all the stuff I've done, some of it a bit contentious, some of it a bit languagey and all that, to have the thing that really is going to stick around in culture be something so harmless, which sounds like damn praise, but it doesn't hurt anyone. It just puts joy into the world and employs hundreds and hundreds of people and creates, like, it's just a good thing in the world. So I'm super lucky. Yeah,
that's exactly what it is. It is a good thing in the world. I saw it with my wife, and I can't wait for our daughter to be old enough for us to go back and see it, because I miss the bit, no plot spoilers here really, but the bit with Mrs. Trunchbull and the, because I had to go to the loo and I hate being that guy, and it's why I always book a seat on the end row, because I would hate to ruin anyone else's enjoyment of any production I'm at. I've some bladder issues Tim.
That's right.
I sit on the end, because at least I know I've got that and I'm not going to annoy other people.
You're staring your bladder in the face, and that's the main thing.
She could be such a cruel mistress,
looking it in the eye. That's good.
Well, let's talk about new projects. Coming to Sky Atlantic this Friday is your brand new comedy drama, Upright.
Yeah.
In this particular case, Upright refers to a piano.
Yeah.
And an incredible journey, both geographically and for the soul. I think that's what we have here. We have something with real heart.
Yeah.
And so please tell everyone about it, because you'll do a much better job than I will.
Yeah, well, Upright, it refers to a piano. I guess metaphorically it also refers to this dude Lucky's journey to sort of being able to put his shoulders back and breathe out a bit, because he's carrying with him the burden, not just of the piano, but of his past and the things he did wrong and stuff. And he has this car crash with this teenage superhero kind of rogue child girl who's just foul-mouthed and mad, and they do this
played by Millie Alcott.
And we do this massive desert road trip together over 8.5 hours, and it's funny, and there's action sequences and, you know, stupidity, but it's very much a sort of because I got to write Matilda and stuff, I think it really thrust me towards this obsession with balance between comedy and heart and comedy and truth and stuff. And it's reflected in a lot of my songs on stage. But, you know, this mission to make people laugh and cry, perhaps within the same 30-second frame, you know, is something I'm obsessed over. And, this from the audiences who have seen this in screenings and stuff, they go, you know, it's a real roller coaster.
Well, you certainly achieved what you were setting out to do in that case. And it must have been really nice, because with the premise of this, you're on this big road trip, you're heading back to family to record this in the incredible landscapes of your home country.
Yeah.
Must have been, the cherry, is it either the cherry on top of the cake, or is it the basis from where everything else grew?
Aren't you clever?
Occasionally.
Yeah, that's right.
You've caught me on a good day.
We've got to watch that Tim Minchin show. It's something to do with a cake.
That's genuinely insightful. It is sort of the basis of the thing, because I lived here in London for 8 years, and then we moved to LA and were there for 4 years, and our kids were born overseas, and then at the beginning of last year we moved back to Australia, and the thing I was working on around that time was this, and so this homecoming idea and kind of having a look at what it feels like to be separated from your people, and when you're from Australia as well, is a real sense of, you know, I miss London so much still, and I love being here, but Australia's my
home. You know, it smells like my home, and the trees are my trees, and so all those things are important, and also just stories of people going home when they've been disconnected from their people are everyone can relate to. Even though Lucky's journey is completely absurd and crazy crap happens, the homecoming and needing to go, you know, it's not too much of a spoiler to say his mum's dying. Mm-hmm. That's why he's going home. He's not been home for 8 years. So everyone has a version, some story about separation and about needing resolution with people you love and stuff. So it really stabs people in the guts in the end.
Well, it's a fabulous series, as I say. It's going to be coming to Sky Atlantic this coming Friday. Thank you very much indeed for swinging by this morning, Tim. Upright's an incredible piece of work. I'm also honoured to say that you joined me on Dave Berry's Dad Pod, my brand new podcast to talk all things dad, and you can download that from wherever you download your podcast. Tim, thank you very much.
Absolute indeed. Pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Enjoying yourself? I hope so, because we get a warm glow when you like our videos. So subscribe for more of the same. Plus, ring the bell icon when you subscribe, and we'll even tell you personally when there's a new one up. Now, as you're here, why not watch another?